There's one signal that I wanted to highlight or ask about because I've been sort of noticing it. It's become a little bit more prevalent, at least in my experience as a user, as a viewer, which is surveys. I've noticed more sort of satisfaction surveys with a variety of questions. I'm wondering about the importance of that signal in the mix as an ingredient in that entire mix. How important are surveys now? And is that going to be, going forward, is that an area that you'll be leaning into in order to get better at suggestions?
Yeah, and I'll answer that, but let me ask you a question, Lou. Do you feel like YouTube is responsive to the answers that you provide in those surveys? Do you feel like it starts to show up in terms of your recommendations over time?
Oof, that's hard for me to say. I've only really started to interact with it very recently. Okay. I think it's having an effect, but it's so hard. It's like you were saying previously, there's so many factors that go into it. And sometimes when you're clicking on a video that you find intriguing, you're not necessarily doing the math as to how you ended up there or what you may have answered that brought you there. Because mm-hmm. If the content itself is captivating, then you're already inside of it. That said, I find that questions on the survey to be interesting, and being a YouTube creator myself, I can't help but wonder the impact of these surveys on content that I publish and how people respond to that, because sentiment is kind of different than some of these other signals, like watch time or click-through rate or something like this. Those are a number. Whereas yeah. these surveys are not, they're kind of a little bit more human.
Yeah, it's and the reason I asked you that question is, and it'll be hopefully become apparent in my answer is, even what you said as the answer is actually kind of the way that those surveys were designed to be a signal into our recommendations, meaning that they. The idea was not meant for them to be an immediate signal per se. And the concept that some of those questions that you might be seeing, what we're trying to get at there is kind of, as you were touching on, a longer term impact, an impact of an understanding of sentiment or satisfaction, which is not something that you can capture through, you know, kind of short-term behavior of a video that you watched, how long you watched it, did you click on that thumbnail, that sort of thing. Those are obviously great signals for immediate feedback and sort of factoring into kind of what gets recommended to you kind of right then and there or next. But one of the concepts that we would like to continue to evolve to is also long-term satisfaction of our viewers after they've had a chance to perhaps reflect on content that they watched and factor that into recommendations over time as well, so that there is a kind of a longer horizon sort of feedback, if you will, as another means to continue to refine and deliver to our users what they're looking for that is not just focused on kind of short-term engagement, that is actually focused on, you know, perhaps a longer-term goal that a particular, you know, viewer might have. So, you know, just to give you a more concrete example, lots of viewers come to YouTube just, you know, like they do on your channel, to learn something new, to learn about, you know, a particular topic that's of interest to them. They can learn something right then and there. And sometimes for viewers, that learning journey is actually something that happens over like a longer period in time, like over the course of several videos. You know, you might, for example, you might be learning algebra. You're not going to learn that in one video. You're going to learn that over the course of 10, 15, 20 videos. And is there a way that we can actually capture that user's satisfaction with, you know, kind of that learning journey on YouTube as a very concrete example, and as a means to continue to make that a better, you know, journey for algebra learners, for example. And so that's the way that you should think about those surveys that pop up occasionally.
Yeah, so I think it's more obvious to me the survey component from the viewer side of things where I feel slightly more confused, or maybe that's the wrong word, intrigued, I should say, is the survey side from the creator perspective. And by this, I mean the fact that I know these surveys are happening for people that are watching my content, but I don't have access to any of those results to know what the sentiment is around a particular video or subject that I cover, which might not be as good as another one. Now, I know if I publish a video that has great results inside of analytics, I'll have all types of markers and feedback stating, hey, do more of that. But it's kind of vague. Whereas if this survey information around satisfaction was available to me, then I might actually be able to tune what I'm publishing as well to better satisfy a group of individuals, a group of viewers, or even regular viewers, if that information is out there.
Yeah, I think that's actually really interesting. And I think what I would say, I'd say a couple things about that. One is if there's a useful signal that we could tease out of this that I think could actually provide insights in terms of, you know, new videos or new types of content that you could produce for your fans, I think that that's, you know, a great idea. And I think it's something that we should consider ultimately putting into YouTube. Yeah, into analytics, into YouTube Studio. Hopefully you've seen that we've really doubled down in terms of insights and trends and cards and things like that that we want to put at your fingertips. So I could imagine something useful getting teased out of this. I think it would be less useful, frankly, if it was sort of the raw data, because as you said, there's so much subjectivity there. It's oftentimes not just tied to one particular video. But there might be some useful creator-facing signals that should come out of that that I think is certainly an interesting idea. And then, you know, the other piece is, the other thing that I would say is that we're also working on more ways for you to interact with your fan base to actually tease out that type of feedback that you're looking for directly, whether it's through a post or a poll that you can do in a post or something like that. Obviously, you know, you can do it directly in a YouTube story or what have you. There's different ways, obviously, that you can do it in the comments, of course. So there are ways that creators tease that out, but actually being able to provide it in sort of like a kind of statistically significant signal through some of this is also something that we would think about.